Can't hear me.
Nope. Mr. Pop.
I'm bored. I'm bored. I'm bored.
How long have we been doing this for?
I'm bored.
Why are they not here yet?
I'm bored!
Why are you shouting?
Well, we start on the wings. I'm bored. I just don't feel like I'm saying it right. It needs more energy.
When were we meant to perform again?
I think we were fourth in line. They must be running behind.
This is my 10th this week, you know. All on Zoom.
Didn't this production will even take place?
We rehearse the scene now.
That wouldn't make it a complete waste of time.
Wouldn't it?
Why is it called Zoom anyway? It's not even a Zoom function.
I suppose you could do this.
Don't.
No, sorry.
We could run it again if you want.
We've run it to death. We've been running it to death all day. We've run it to death, resurrected it, then run it to death again.
I guess we don't want to lose the spark.
No.
The players do tell you in Bartholomew Fair.
Don't.
What secret consumptions and rascals you are.
I hear it again.
For one of their actors, it seems, had the fate by one of your trade to be fleeced of late.
You have it.
Then fall to your prayers, you that are waylayers.
Am I muted?
They're fit to choose all the world that can cheat players. For he hath the art and no man the worse, whose cunning can pilfer the pilferer's purse. Youth, thou's better been starved by thy nurse than live to be hanged for cutting a purse. Youth, thou's better been starved by thy nurse.
I'm starting to sympathise.
Do you think it's good?
I think it's the same as it was 2 hours ago, or three, or four, or however many centuries back.
Youth, thou hast better been starved.
Do you think they've forgotten us?
Might just be a busy run.
Maybe we should drop a message in the chat.
What, and seem impatient?
You're right.
No, we're better off just...
We're waiting it out, yeah. We really ought to complain.
You know that the moment we complain will be precisely the moment they show up.
Don't we have rights? Isn't there an actors union?
They're no good. They'll bow to anything.
It's a farce.
Maybe it's a test.
Why?
To improve our chemistry.
What?
On stage.
What stage? There is no stage. And what chemistry? You're just pixels on a screen. Just photons. There's no mass to it. No weight. No substance. Your performance will only ever be two-dimensional at best.
Well, maybe it can improve our physics then. We can work on our rapport.
What's wrong with our rapport?
There's nothing wrong with our rapport.
There's nothing wrong with our rapport.
It's a strong rapport. I'm just suggesting we work on our rapport to improve the rapport that already exists. It can't hurt.
Can't it? Fine. What do you want to know?
Not like that. It's got to be organic.
Okay, what do you organically want to know?
I don't know. How are you?
Fine.
Good. They're taking their time.
We're taking our time.
What would you be doing otherwise?
No, I've got projects.
Oh, here we go. Now we're getting somewhere. What kind of projects?
I go for a run in the mornings.
Okay, nice. Staying active, keeping fit, getting that body in shape.
Yes.
Although I can't really see on the call, of course.
No.
So are you living with anyone?
No.
Well, I guess there's nothing wrong with doing stuff for yourself.
What's that noise?
My boyfriend, hang on. Hang on. Sorry about that.
What was that?
He's trying to fix the recording that he broke.
You recorded yourself?
It helps me remember.
So what about you?
Oh, I'm living with my boyfriend.
No, do you have any hobbies?
Oh, well, I usually paint.
Well, what do you paint?
Compasses. Well, I haven't done it much recently, though. He doesn't like the smell.
No. Oh.
But you know, I do other stuff.
Yeah.
I exercise.
Runs?
Yeah.
Well, I think we're ready now.
You think?
Now we've built a rapport.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we are. That's good because maybe we weren't ready before. Maybe this delay is a blessing in disguise because we were able to build a rapport.
We do have a rapport, don't we?
I don't know. God, we're overthinking now. That's what time does. It makes you overthink. Turns shadows into potential threats, single phrases into rambling verses.
Perhaps the best thing to do now is to relax and not to agonise.
No, we can't fritter away precious moments with agonising. We could be using this time for something constructive. You know, there's always room for improvement. We could be improving right now if we just put ourselves the task. Is my lighting good?
Your lighting's fine.
Your lighting's good too. Well, that's something. They can't pick us up on the lighting.
Look, we'll only undo what we've just done.
You're right. Distraction's what we need. Keep it natural, keep it organic.
Good.
They'll have decided whether they want you within the first 10 seconds of you entering anyway.
Really? How do you know that?
It's hardly a secret. The moment you enter the room, they've made a judgment. You're put into a camp. Romantic lead or clown. Hero or villain. Innocent or seductress. What camp would you put me into?
Well, I know you too well now. Confuses the instinct. We've built a rapport. But I'd probably say...
I don't want to know. Seems unfair, though, to be judged like that. They should at least wait until I've finished.
They did say they were going to call us in, didn't they? We haven't missed it, have we?
I don't see how we could.
Fucking hell.
Is that your bed?
Yeah, why?
Just interested.
My bed?
No, just... interesting choice of sheets.
What's wrong with my sheets?
It's just there's a whole politics to backgrounds now, isn't there? And what it reflects about your character. You know, do you choose a plain background to avoid scrutiny or a bookshelf to show you're cultured? It's like a Renaissance painting. The kings used to have their portraits taken next to pillars or on a horse to symbolise strength.
So?
Well, I see you've chosen the unmade bed.
Well, I left my pillow at my parents'. Is that your bed?
Oh, it's Jack's.
It looks very tidy.
Yeah. Keeps things very tidy.
Maybe I should tidy up.
What if they call us in?
Oh, you're right. There's no time. I mean, what can they be asking them to do in there? These aren't long scenes. How much time do they need?
Maybe we got the instructions wrong. Maybe we're meant to, like, rehearse it in some particular way.
You're doing it again.
What?
Overthinking.
Well, what have we have?
Look, we've been given a script and told to read it. It's 2 pages. If there's something we've missed after all this time, then we deserve to fail.
God, I suddenly feel so nervous. Do I look nervous?
I don't know. The lighting isn't very...
You said my lighting was good. Is my lighting not good?
Yes, you do look nervous. I see it now.
It's like we've been here so long, I've always forgotten we're at an audition. I've forgotten what I was nervous about, and that's what's made me nervous.
I really think we should put a message in the chat.
We've been over this.
Look, I don't think it's rude to ask. Make up an excuse. Say one of us has got an appointment soon.
Maybe we could message one of the other auditionees. You see how long they've been waiting.
What if they lie? What if they try to psych us out?
Right. We'll message the host.
Okay, what do we say?
Hello? Oh, no, hi.
Hey.
Do we need a greeting?
I think it would be polite.
Which is the right one to go with?
Oh, I never know.
Hi. Hi. Definitely hi. It's the casual bridge between hey and hello.
Okay, so we just said hi.
Right. Hi. Then what should we say?
Sorry.
Oh, not sorry. What are we apologising for? Sorry makes us seem weak.
Sorry, you're right. How about I have an appointment at 4?
Better make it 5 in case 4 is too soon and then we have to leave for an appointment that we don't have.
Let's say 4:30.
Perfect.
Okay, so, hi.
I thought we settled on hey.
No, hi, it's a casual bridge, unless you want to change it to hey.
No, hi is good.
Right, okay, so, hi.
Start.
I have an appointment at 4:30. Do you know if we'll be called in soon?
Oh, good. Nice, they're snappy.
Best wishes?
Ooh, maybe just a thanks.
Okay, good. Thanks. It's sent.
Well, now what?
Well, now we wait for them to reply.
Maybe we should run it again.
Well, we've sent it now.
Well, I mean the scene.
I'm not running it again.
Okay, I hear you. So, are you part of a bubble or...?
Right, if then it comes soon, I'm leaving.
You'll leave?
I've had enough. I'm wasting away here.
If you leave, I have to as well.
No, you don't.
I can't read the part by myself.
Fine.
Any minute. It'll be any minute at all. 1 minute or 20,000. Could be any of them. So are you?
What?
Part of a bubble.
No. Are you?
Well, I've got Jack.
That must be nice.
I hate to be alone.
Okay.
Maybe you should join a bubble.
Who with?
No, I assume you've got friends.
They haven't replied yet.
Oh, your friends?
No, the hosts.
You've asked to be in a bubble with the hosts?
No, they haven't replied to our message from before.
Just wait, they'll see it.
We sent it to ourselves.
What?
We've sent it to ourselves. The chat's only between you and me.
What, we're stuck? Trapped in this echo chamber, this void.
Right, that's it. I'm leaving.
You can't leave.
Look, they're clearly not coming. They've forgotten us.
We don't know that for sure.
It's been hours.
Oh, and he can't walk away now.
They'd hardly notice.
Oi, my audition is not going to be ruined because you can't wait 5 minutes.
5 minutes? You think? Oh, all right, how about we make a deal? If they don't come in the next 5 minutes, we're both leaving, all right?
Right.
That noise again.
There must be, like, some other way to grab their attention.
Brick through the window might work.
Oh, look! There! A call for help! We can call for help!
It's a bit desperate, isn't it?
What's the alternative?
Call for help. We're not drowning. Call for help is something you do when you drown.
You were the one who wanted to contact them.
Contact them, yes, but call for help.
What's wrong with call for help?
It wouldn't be so bad if it was request assistance. I could work with request assistance, but calling for help is just a bit embarrassing.
I guess you'll have to wait.
We're drowning.
It's just 5 more minutes.
Would you really want to work for people like that anyway?
Who else would we work with?
There will be other opportunities.
And how many will you let pass by because there might be others?
What, so you're just going to accept this?
Maybe. Yes, I will accept this.
Why?
Because what else?
And that's it.
But it's true.
I'm leaving.
You can't leave.
Why not?
Because I'm auditioning.
What for?
Because I want to.
Why?
I need the company, that's why. I need to feel like I'm doing something.
And this is something.
It's better than nothing.
Why aren't you the one leaving? You're the one who's actually got company.
It's better than nothing. Shit, isn't it?
The best roses rise from a bed of shit.
Same is true for potatoes.
Well, thanks for killing the imagery. Have you heard the good news?
No.
Me neither.
Do you think this performance will even take place?
Don't say that.
I'm bored. It's not a permanent thing. It has an expiry date. It was just a bit of fun to pass the time at first. It's some company. I thought it would be. I didn't know it would go on this. But you know when you don't really know someone and they don't really know you? It's like being alone, isn't it? Except it's worse. It is worse than that because at least when you're alone, you can relax. you can be yourself and there's nothing to mold to. But here, it's like you're half yourself, you know? Like there's a part of you you can't show. And that other half is filled with whatever other stuff you think they'd want to see to make you seem whole. Like a performance. Like being trapped in a performance.
I guess I sometimes think you need the other people to fill in the blanks, to make up what's missing.
Well, it must start somewhere.
What?
If we're all just taking from each other, there must be someone who knows who they are.
In Shakespeare's time, actors were seen as at the height of social depravity, up there with vagabonds or prostitutes. They were idlers, liars, thieves of identity, itinerants moving from town to town, never settling. And because they never settled, they were dangerous. The rest of the world seemed to want to pin them down, bottle them, but they just kept moving, taking faces and tongues as they went along. Maybe that's what an actor is, at the heart of it all. A thief, touring from town to town, scene to scene. And when they stop, they cease to be an actor. The scene stops, and the drama dies.
The payers do tell you, Bartholomew Fair, what secret consumptions and rascals you are. For one of their actors, it seemed, had the fate by one of their trade to be fleeced of late. For he hath the art, and no man the worse, whose cunning can pilfer the pilferer's purse. Youth, youth, thou hast better been starved by thy nurse than live to be hanged for cutting a purse. Five minutes is up.
Yeah.
I guess we should leave.
Yeah.
You haven't left.
Neither of you.
Should we run it again?